Hello there, how you doing today? I hope you're all well. Today we're going into r/ I don't work here, lady, where some entitled Karens and Kyles assume the original poster of these stories work somewhere. But guess what? They don't. Anyway, if you enjoy, like, subscribe, and leave a comment with your thoughts. Now, without further ado, let's get started, okay? That's my hoodie, not a dog leash. So, this just happened. I, 38 female, have worked different retail and customer service jobs most of my life, and I've dealt with my fair share of entitled customers at work. I've even been mistaken as an employee at a bunch of stores. But this was my first confrontational experience as a customer. My daughter and I were at Wally World getting dog food and a couple last-minute ingredients for dinner. I'm loading a large bag of dog food while trying to keep a toddler entertained. And that's when it happened. An entitled Karen appeared. Obnoxiously pink outfit, fake gaudy jewelry, badly dyed hair, and nails long enough to make a tiger jealous. I didn't even know she was there until I felt a sharp jab in the shoulder with those nails. I turned around to an expression that could curdle milk. I say, "Yeah?"
"Load 4 bags of dog food in my cart," she demanded, pointing at the 40-pound bag I just loaded into my cart.
"No, please. No polite would or could you. Just a terse order like she was talking to someone so beneath her that she couldn't be bothered saying anything else. I wasn't even slightly resembling a worker since I was wearing jeans, sneakers, and a black hoodie from a local haunted house. Not to mention my daughter in the cart next to me. Still, I wasn't in a rush, and my daughter wasn't being fussy. If Karen had, I don't know, asked nicely, I would have gladly helped. I've done that a bunch of times before, and I've always been glad to help. So long as I get a please and a thank you from the person I'm helping. Instead, I just said, "I don't work here, I'm shopping." I was hoping that being direct and staying close to my daughter would show that I was busy. But alas, no siree. Her lip curled even harder and sounded insulted when she said,
"So you're not going to help me?"
I just said, "No, I need to finish my shopping," not wanting to risk getting caught up in one of the many "I don't work here, lady" stories that I read. I grabbed my cart with my daughter and started walking away. I just wanted to get us away from the situation ASAP. And that, my dearest reader, was my mistake. Never turn your back on a rabid animal. I barely registered Karen's indignant huff before she grabbed me by the hood of my sweater and yanked. This freaked me out from suddenly being choked. I'm someone that's been trained in self-defense, martial arts, and was raised around a bunch of bikers. If maternal instincts weren't telling me to get my daughter out of danger, I probably would have done a lot more damage to the woman than I did. I swung my arm back as hard as I could to force her to let go. I made contact with something hard enough that she let go with a yelp, and I hightailed it to the front of the store to report what happened. The employees, manager, and security were on their game, and immediately went looking for Karen as soon as I told them what happened and gave a description. Unfortunately, Karen was gone by the time they went looking for her. The manager still contacted police, and a report was filed. I definitely wanted to press charges if I could. According to security, after I hit the woman's bracelet-covered wrist with my closed fist and ran off, she looked really upset and insulted, but then got a Oh, shit. Look. She started looking around until she looked directly at the camera. Karen then grabbed her purse and sprinted out of the store, leaving her cart and groceries behind. I guess she wasn't a complete idiot after all, and realized how badly she messed up. The manager promised to keep an eye out for her. The police said they would contact me if needed. My hand got bruised from how hard I hit her, and she left a line in my neck from trying to choke me. My daughter had no idea that anything bad happened. She was giggling when I was running her and the car to the front. The next day, I get a call from the officer I talked to. Either Karen grew a conscience, or someone forced her to turn herself in. She showed up at the police station the next day, looking like a scolded puppy when she got there. That's at least according to the officer. The officer asked if I still wanted to press charges, and said she'd likely get probation or community service. And I told him that I did indeed still want to. Part of me wonders, did she actually feel bad? Did her husband, wife, or whatever ask her why she didn't get the dog food and force her to confess? Or did she come in so she wouldn't be arrested and get a lighter sentence? I don't know. I'm just surprised she did. Boy. That's a story. Anyway, on to the next one, shall we? I don't work here. I just want to get stupidly drunk. Disclaimers on mobile, non-English speaker. So this incident happened almost 10 years ago. At that moment in time, I was working in a hospital in England. I'm a nurse, and living across a 24-hour ASTA. I had finished my fifth in a row shift, which started really bad, and ended way worse than I imagined. That day, while my shift officially ended at 20 o'clock, military clock time, so for the people who go by like 12 a.m. and 12 p.m., that would be like 10 at night. I managed to get home at around 22:30. I was in the mentality of getting drunk to start my 3 days off, but I had no energy to go pub hopping. I haven't gone inside the house yet, having a cigarette outside, still in my scrubs, when I remembered I had no alcohol in the house. So I decided to cross the street and visit the 24-hour ASTA. It's a supermarket chain. I go in, still in my scrubs, grab a cart and hit the alcohol aisle. I notice two packs of a certain dark beer and move towards the whiskeys. As I'm browsing the whiskeys, I notice a lady is watching me. I grab a bottle of bourbon and realize I haven't had anything but a piece of pizza all day, and I'm kind of hungry. So I hit the ready meals next. As I walk towards the ready meals, I notice the lady is following. As I reach to grab my first meal, I hear the dreaded sound that has made thousands of workers to either quit or consider murder.
Excuse me?
I turn around to see the lady was following me. We shall refer to her as Karen from now on. Karen, pointing at a bag of frozen chicken in her cart.
I need two more of these.
So, I'm in a really I don't give a fuck mood.
So I need you to get me two more.
Sorry, can't do.
What? What do you mean can't do? Go back in the back and bring me two more now.
At that point, I realize she thinks I work there. Sorry, I don't work here.
Don't give me that bull. Just bring me the bloody wings.
Are you colorblind? I was wearing dark blue scrubs. The workers had black trousers and green polos.
How dare you?
She said back in a shocked, accusatory tone. Anyways, there's an employee over there. He's 2 aisles over filling shelves. Go ask him. After I said that, I walked away. As I'm paying for my booze and food, I see her approaching with an employee accompanying her. Karen, pointing at me.
That's him. He didn't help me and was rude. I want him fired.
The employee said, ma'am, he's wearing his hospital scrubs. I can't fire a customer.
But he's wearing a uniform. He should have helped me.
The employee, which I presume to be the night manager, looks back at me. I say, don't look at me. I just want to get stupidly drunk, tapping the beers. Karen tries to say something more, but at that point, I had already paid, so I grabbed my groceries and I walked out. I saw her one other time shopping there at night, but I wasn't wearing my scrubs, and she probably did not recognize me. Yeah, that sounds about right, about what a Karen would do. Anyway, on to the last story of the day. Boop! I'm not a cop, but I'll help you out. Here's a little nice one from earlier this evening. I work as a news photographer in a major city. This evening I pulled spot news duty, which is my favorite. I'm very good at it. I listen to scanners, follow breaking newspapers and blogs, and generally stand by for stuff to happen. Two key elements of the story are, one, my vehicle looks very much like a cop car, as we are taught in 8th grade biology. Form follows function. It's a Ford Explorer festooned with antennae for radios and scanners, and has a Giotto desk to hold my laptop in the passenger seat, so I can run internet searches and listen to IP-based scanner sources. It also has strobes, white and amber, construction lights for roadside safety. I can't use them while moving, but it still has an undercover cop look to it. The vehicle is outfitted to do my job efficiently. Point two is that while in standby mode, I have found a parking spot that is near major intersections to get around town fast, while not being easy for people to sneak up on me unaware. It could also be construed as a radar trap for those who think I'm official. A bit before sunset, I'm sitting there surfing Reddit on my phone and listening to the scanners. A pickup pulled in beside me. I was thinking it was a water department supervisor. This spot is a driveway into the pumping station with a convenient porta potty on site, and I was half expecting to get kicked out. A bummer, but oh well. Nope, it was a couple polite, good old boys from out of town asking me about nearby fishing spots. Fortunately, we were right about the corner from some nice locations I knew and could quickly provide directions. After an admonition to refrain from eating what they caught, urban rivers and all that, the polite young men thanked me and went on their way. Not 10 minutes later, another vehicle pulls up. He was lost and was hoping I could help him find his way. Fortunately, I was able to explain the logic behind the way the city is laid out, and within a few moments, he grasped where he needed to go and where he needed to go. I'm sure these folks think the city employs some very helpful undercover cops now, and I'm not one to dissuade their conclusions. I, for one, found the two pleasant interactions a very nice change of pace from my usual evening activities, and I have started my weekend a bit more upbeat than usual. When I can, I like to end these videos on a lighter story. I hope you all enjoyed them. Remember to like, subscribe, and leave a comment with your thoughts down below. And without further ado, I will see you all in the next video.